Hello friends, today we'll discuss about lino and gauze weaving. This term gauze came from the place of origin Gaza, which is in Palestine near Israel, where this was initially woven. And actually nowadays this gauze fabric term is used for fairly open structure fabrics. They may be either plain woven or lino woven. Whereas in lino weaving, there are two strands of warp yarns, and one is termed as crossing end and other is called the standard end. And the crossing end moves from one side to other side of the standard end in between the peaks. So if we can see here, if we term the green end as a standard end and purple end, this purple yarn as the crossing end, then we can see that this purple end changes its side from left to right in between the picks. Like for the first pick, it is on the left side, and then for the second pick, it goes on the right side, and then it changes in between the picks. And these, in this condition, in this crossover condition, these are locked in by these weft yarns. Okay, so if we define it, so in lino weaving, certain ends termed as crossing ends are passed from side to side of what termed as standard ends, and are bound in by these and are bound in by the weft in these positions. This is another very good example of lino fabrics. The crossing and standard ends may be arranged in with each other in various proportions. Like we can use one standard end and one crossing end. Also, we can use the stripes of the standard end crossing ends, like two standard end, two crossing, three standard end, two crossing, or vice versa in various conditions. So there are practically unlimited ways. But an essential condition is that each group of crossing and standard ends must be placed in one split of the reed. Nearly all kind of yarn and yarn combinations can be used, but in open perforated structures particularly, the thread should be as smooth, as uniform in thickness, and with as little loose fibers on the surface as possible. As the warp yarns in the lino weaving are subjected to higher degree of friction and greater stresses, their average strength should be higher than the minimum required for normal weaving. So as there is a very higher degree of friction, so the fibers susceptible to static electrification should be well lubricated or should be omitted. So generally we can use all the natural fibers. If we use any fibers susceptible to static electrification, that then it should be well lubricated. There are many use cases for the lino fabrics, like these bags for vegetables and fruits, and these are used for curtains, shirtings, some dress materials also. In fact, these are used for geotextiles also, and in agro textiles like bird protection nets. Actually, these are very open structures, net-like structures. So wherever we can use nets, we can make nets on lino, and we can employ lino fabrics. These are fairly open structures, so air and sunlight can pass through very easily. Now let's discuss about the principles of lino weaving structures. As we've discussed, that if we can see here, there are two strands of warp and this is the weft yarn. So in A, if this is the first pick, then crossing end is in the top shed, and the standard yarn is in the bottom shed, and the crossing yarn is on the left side of the standard end. But in the next pick, the crossing yarn is again on the top side, and standard yarn is on again on the bottom side, but now in this case, in this next pick, the crossing yarn is on the right side of the standard yarn. So in between these two picks, when one pick is inserted and when second shed is forming, the crossing yarn crosses through beneath the standard yarn. अगर मैं हिंदी में बोलूं, तो हमें यहाँ पे दो वार्प यार्न दिख रहे हैं. ये है स्टैंडर्ड यार्न जो वाइट कलर का है, और ये ब्लैक वाला है क्रॉसिंग यार्न. तो जब हम पहली पिक देख रहे हैं, तो इसमें क्रॉसिंग यार्न टॉप पोजीशन में है पिक में, और स्टैंडर्ड यार्न बॉटम पोजीशन पे है. ठीक है, जब दूसरी पिक होगी, दूसरी पिक में भी क्रॉसिंग यार्न टॉप पोजीशन पे ही है, स्टैंडर्ड यार्न बॉटम पोजीशन पे ही है. लेकिन पहली पिक में क्रॉसिंग यार्न लेफ्ट साइड को था, अगली पिक में क्रॉसिंग यार्न राइट साइड पे आ गया है स्टैंडर्ड यार्न के. और जब ये दोनों पिकों के बीच में जो इंटरवल था, उस टाइम पे जब ये दूसरी पिक फॉर्म हुई है, उससे पहले क्रॉसिंग यार्न स्टैंडर्ड यार्न के नीचे से घूम के गया है. ठीक है, तो ये इस तरह का, ये जे में जो आप स्ट्रक्चर देख रहे हैं, इस टाइप का स्ट्रक्चर एक बनता है. ठीक है, इसको समझने के लिए हम बना के देखते हैं स्ट्रक्चर को. ये हमारा स्टैंडर्ड यार्न है और ये हमारा क्रॉसिंग यार्न है रेड कलर वाला. ठीक है, पहली पिक में, जो क्रॉसिंग यार्न है ये टॉप पोजीशन में है और स्टैंडर्ड यार्न बॉटम पोजीशन पे है. अभी हमारा ये एक पिक इंसर्ट हो गई. ठीक है, अभी इस पिक में हमारा जो क्रॉसिंग यार्न था वो इसके ऊपर था और स्टैंडर्ड यार्न इसके नीचे था. अब अगली पिक में क्या होगा, स्टैंडर्ड यार्न तो इसी पोजीशन में रहेगा, लेकिन जो क्रॉसिंग यार्न होगा वो हमारा यहाँ से इसके नीचे से, जो हमारा स्टैंडर्ड यार्न था उसके नीचे से क्रॉस करके और दूसरी साइड जाएगा, और दूसरी साइड जाने के बाद अभी यहाँ पे सेकंड पिक इंसर्ट होगी. अब ये जो सेकंड पिक इंसर्ट होगी, इसमें से फिर से हमारा जो क्रॉसिंग यार्न है ये इसके टॉप से ही रहेगा और स्टैंडर्ड यार्न बॉटम साइड में था, और फिर से थर्ड पिक से पहले ये क्रॉसिंग यार्न इसको नीचे से क्रॉस करके और फिर से टॉप पोजीशन पे अपना शेड ओपन होगा. ठीक है, तो इस तरीके से अगर हम देखेंगे तो क्रॉसिंग यार्न जो है वो अपनी पोजीशन चेंज कर रहा है, एक बार लेफ्ट साइड में है स्टैंडर्ड यार्न के, अगली बार राइट साइड में है, और इन बिटवीन वो जो स्टैंडर्ड यार्न है उसके नीचे से क्रॉस कर रहा है. इफ यू कैन सी देयर मे बी टू पॉसिबिलिटीज, दैट ईदर स्टैंडर्ड यार्न फॉर्म्स द टॉप शेड और द क्रॉसिंग यार्न फॉर्म द टॉप शेड. सो इन द फर्स्ट सिनेरियो वी हैव लर्न दैट इफ द क्रॉसिंग यार्न फॉर्म्स द टॉप शेड, देन क्रॉसिंग यार्न क्रॉसेस द स्टैंडर्ड यार्न फ्रॉम बीनीथ इट एंड फॉर्म्स द टॉप शेड इन नेक्स्ट पिक ऑल्सो. ठीक है, बट इफ वट इफ द स्टैंडर्ड यार्न फॉर्म्स द टॉप शेड एंड क्रॉसिंग यार्न फॉर्म्स द बॉटम शेड, इन दैट सिनेरियो ऑल्सो द क्रॉसिंग यार्न क्रॉसेस द स्टैंडर्ड यार्न. इफ इन द फर्स्ट पिक, लाइक हियर वी कैन सी दैट क्रॉसिंग यार्न इज ऑन द टॉप शेड एंड द स्टैंडर्ड यार्न इज ऑन द राइट साइड ऑफ द क्रॉसिंग यार्न बट ऑन इन द बॉटम शेड. In the next pick, the crossing yarn crosses the standard yarn from above it and forms the bottom shed again, whereas the standard yarn is again on the top shed. Okay, so there are these two possibilities. Now, If we see the structures, there are four examples of these structures. If you can see here in the diagram C, the standard yarn, which is in white color, is in the bottom shed. As we can see, this is the weft yarn, and the standard yarn in the white color is at the bottom end, and the crossing yarn, which is dark black color, is in the top shed. Then this type of structure is formed, which is shown in the C diagram C. Okay, if we see the H and I structure, where the standard yarn forms the top shed and the crossing yarn forms the bottom shed, this J here we can see the J, this structure is formed. Here we can see that the white yarn, which is standard yarn, which is on this is on the top shed, and the black yarn, which is crossing yarn, which is in the bottom shed. So these two fabrics are actually identical to each other. They are just the reverse copy of each other. Like the bottom part, bottom side of the one fabric is the top side of another fabric. Here we can see this in G diagram, that if we see it, see this fabric in once from one side, then all the standard yarns are on the top side, and if we see it in the back side of the fabric, then all the standard yarn are on the top side, and vice versa. If we see here the difference between this C and D, we can notice that in diagram D, the standard yarn, which is in white color, are fairly stiff. They are fairly straight, whereas the D, whereas the crossing yarn, which is in the black color, they are they looks fairly slack. Okay, so what happens if we feed these two standard yarn and crossing yarn from same beam? Then the tension in both the yarns will be equal, and they will equally be displaced. So we will have a structure like C or E. But if we feed these two yarns from different beams, like we have one beam for standard yarn and one beam for crossing yarn, then the standard yarn will be fairly slack, and the crossing yarn will have higher tension. And so this type of D and E, D and F type of structure will be formed. So we can see that although single warp beam can be used, but in some cases the effect with such a difference in the take up are produced that it is necessary for the two series of the ends to be bought from the separate beams. Like for standard end, we need a different warp beam, and for the crossing end, we need a separate warp beams. Now the method of production of these lino structures, there are mainly five method of production. First one is flat steel dupe with an eye, second is flat steel dupe with a slot, third is gauze and tug reed mechanism, fourth is eyed needle with slider frame devices, and fifth is rotating bobbin and gear disc mounting. This fifth one is only used for the salvage mechanism, salvage manufacturing. So this is not a commercial method of manufacturing lino fabrics as a whole. This is only used for lino salvage manufacturing. Thank you friends, that's all for now. In next video we will discuss in detail one method of production of lino fabric in detail. Thank you.